Laura, Laura Parton, I am the Great Mother. Awake now, Laura, my child. And Laura, know the planet you inhabit. Know the time you move through it. Awaken the memories that sleep within you. Laura, you must know and feel everything. This is Mother Earth. This is your home. Awake unto it.
Laura, how many days has it been since the crash? Time just seems to fade into the distance for me now. It's strange, but I don't feel sad. The snow will soon cover my body. Time will cease to exist, and I'll disappear under the thickening layer of snow. And in that whiteness, all this will transform itself into water and earth. Over a longer period of time than I ever could have imagined. And maybe one day, I'll come back again as a very small flower. I'll blossom and grow. There's an interesting thought for you, Laura, don't you think? Me as a plant? I've never so much as even had a plant in my apartment. Now I'm on my way to being reincarnated as one. Just think. Someday, someone may walk past me. They may be laughing or crying when they do. They may be full of hope or in deep despair. But it won't matter to me then, because a flower doesn't care what it has. doesn't have. It just is, protruding from the snow, waving in the breeze. But it's different with you, Laura. You must survive. Don't worry about me. I'll be staying here, thinking of you, dreaming of you. Laura, it's okay. You can do it. If anyone can, it's you. I know that.
Then a fool you shall die.
Thank you.
words, I will take your ears, and these words will be the last you ever hear. How do you feel now? Grovel in fear. First you are blind, then you are deaf. And now you will move no longer. Do you understand what that means? Death, it means death. The certain death that is yours. And you will be lost in the vast abyss for all eternity.
It's time to say goodbye. Oh, Laura, don't be sad. You'll be all right. It's okay. You'll be able to make it through. And look, I have something special to give you. Here it is. I hope you'll think of me every time you look at it. I've put it away in your keepsake. Laura, don't forget me. David. Well, I guess it's that time. Farewell. Goodbye.
What is this? What's happening? My body. My mind. The pain. Stop it. How could I? It's not possible.
Laura? Laura? Laura, can you hear me? The evil here has been destroyed. You can move again now. Laura, the time has come for you to bond with that fearsome power. Though you cannot see nor can you hear, you must slowly go forward, my child, one step at a time. And with this new power, this unknown force, you will bring salvation. You, Laura, will save your world. Feel the earth underfoot, my child. Awaken the sleeping memory of your wings. And believe in the power that lies in the palm of your hands. That power will grant you miraculous things. Now go, my child. Laura, child of destiny, born across the shores of time. Listen well, my child. You do not know that this apparently endless universe does not have an end. That time, so infinite to misleading senses, will one day stop. You know so little, for you are but a child, a newborn. You must journey forth again, and this voyage will be far longer and much more terrifying. Now is the time to find him. Do you remember? Do you remember the name of the one who saved you? It was he who safeguarded your soul. Go and find him, and thus forge that power at last into one. Laura, my child, call his name. Speak his name, so that all lives and all that will be born shall be saved. Call him and recreate yourself as you were meant to be. Now, now, Laura.
David.
Drop this. Here. You wouldn't want to lose it, Laura. Oh, I'm sorry. I couldn't help seeing your name on this. And besides, I feel like we've met before. That book you have. You read Kimberly Fox? I've read some of her work. I've never met anyone else who's even heard of her. She isn't widely recognized. At least, not yet. My favorite piece in this book is this. This poem, Light. It's about a sort of hypothetical woman, the poet's imaginary best friend. This woman is, oh, I get it now. That's why I felt like we'd met before. Ah, you remind me of her. For me, if that sounds strange, but, well, it is strange. I highly recommend it. It's a wonderful poem. Everything Kimberly Fox writes is so filled with hope and love of life. Oh, Laura, look. So beautiful. Well, anyway, I guess I'll be going.
David!